Today we are going to build a very nice and clean and white PC with some black parts in it for racial diversity. This is going to be an upper mid-range build for gaming and productivity. Hey guys, I am Siddharth and let's pretend that this video was shot according to the timeline of the script, and I can guarantee that you will also be very surprised by the end result. I was planning to use the white version of the TUF GT501 to give this build a nice stormtrooper theme, but that wasn't available this month, so we decided to go with the Corsair 4000D, which is also a great choice for a PC build for professionals. It looks very clean while still retaining a lot of character, and with its open grille on the front, we are also going to get very good airflow. This system will be powered by a Corsair RM850X, and I think that this case was designed for a mid-range PSU, so the 850X is a very tight fit in it, but this is not the first time that you are watching a scene like this. The motherboard that we have today is quite unique and special. As the name suggests, the ASUS ProArt B550 Creator is targeted towards professionals and creators, and so it offers some special features that you don't see on other motherboards. In addition to the dual 2.5 gigabit Ethernet ports, this is also the first AMD board to have two Thunderbolt 4 USB 3.2 Gen 2 ports, which can deliver speeds up to 40 Gbps, along with other Thunderbolt features like display out. I also like how professional it looks with the translucent IO cover and the big VRM heatsinks over its 12 plus 2 power stage design, which will be easily more than enough for the CPU that we'll use. It also supports ProArt Creator Hub for monitoring and integration with other ProArt products, and ASUS Control Center Express also offers some really cool controls over your PC, like being able to disable USB ports and locking the registry editor. You can also use the software blacklist to disable malware like PUBG emulators. We also have two-way AI noise cancellation here, which performs amazingly well as we have seen in my previous videos, and because it is two-way, you can also cancel out the noise on incoming audio, which is going to be very useful with all the virtual interactions that we are having these days. Do give this video a thumbs up if you are liking it so far, and I am also going to have a super epic PC build coming soon, which is so cool that I can't even talk about it yet, so do subscribe so you don't miss it. The AMD Ryzen 7 5800X is going to be the perfect choice for a mid to high-end PC because 8 cores and 16 threads with 36 MB cache are actually easily enough for most productivity tasks, and being on 7nm Zen 3 architecture, we also get practically the top-level gaming performance on this. We removed the non-RGB fans that come pre-installed and replaced them with 3 of the Frostek FS120 ARGB fans. I had great experience with them in a previous build, and these can also be daisy chained for power and RGB, which keeps the system clean. We also installed an RGB fan from Enermax because YOLO. Now we'll install RAM, for which we have two of the 8GB sticks of Corsair Dominator RGB. These really have some of the most unique RGB lighting, for which the IQ software offers a lot of effects and customizability, and I think that this can also be linked to Aura Sync, which is awesome. Cooling our CPU will be the ROG Strix LC240 RGB, which looks really right for this build in this white version. The RGB fans have very cool patterns on them, and they will also help in compensating for the lack of RGB strips in our build. One issue I felt with this cooler was that it was impossible to keep the ROG logo upright without making the cables go snaky snake like this, but the good part about it is that it just had the easiest installation method of any cooler that I have used. We of course have to have custom sleeved extension cables in this PC, and that will be from Sensei Mods, and I have to say that in addition to looking really great, these cables are also very easy to work with, so you can bend them for routing easily, but they still retain some nice curves. You can also configure the exact pattern and color of combs and connectors that you want on their website, so I can 100% recommend them. Now is the time for storage. And we have a 500GB NVMe drive from the Indian brand Astra, along with another 500GB SSD from Samsung. The ProArt motherboard has these very handy tabs that make installation of SSDs very easy, so this is something that every motherboard should have, so you don't have to feel like killing yourself as you lose the tiny SSD screws in the PSU shroud. Creators also need a lot of storage as their homework folder gets very large with the 4K files, so we are also installing a 10TB WD Gold hard drive from WD. We have the ASUS TUF RTX 3070 as the GPU of our choice, and it is a pretty great mid to high range performer that will be perfect for our use case. The TUF variant is also one of the very few cards with all metal construction and military grade capacitors for better durability and performance, which can be monitored and tweaked by their very unsurprisingly named GPU Tweak 2 utility. The other 3000 series TUF GPUs that I have tested have performed exceptionally well, so I am also expecting a similar cooling performance here, and despite its TUF aesthetics, it doesn't look out of place in a build like this because of its simple design. There isn't a lot of space on the backside of this case for thick cables with in-cable capacitors, so we aren't going to win any awards for our cable management, but as the saying goes, the real beauty is on the outside. Closing the lid wasn't easy, but we were able to do it along with attaching the side panel. We then decided to shatter the tempered glass side panel to further enhance the airflow, so the footage from this point will be shot without the side panel. So now let's see what the final result looks like. And well, that is a very neat looking PC. Now there are of course cleaner PC builds in the world, but this is the cleanest PC that I have built, and it just goes super well with my whole setup with this nano white marble desk, so I am very happy about that. And in fact, this looks even cleaner without the side panel because you don't get unwanted reflections. This is also a relatively balanced build, and for creative applications, the 5800X and 3070 are actually very good choices that provide a very good value, and the build just provides a good overall value with our case and motherboard choices. Here is a breakdown of the pricing if you are looking to build a similar PC, and I'll have links in the video description if you want to check out the current pricing of any of these components, as that is fluctuating a lot in the current scenario. So that was it for this video. Do let me know your thoughts about this build in the comment section below. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it, or a thumbs down if you disliked it. Subscribe with bell, follow me on socials. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.